coming into McCarley, Mississippi. On the way to the lake to see if my sailboat is still there. Planning a sailing trip down the Mississippi River in about 3 weeks, but haven't seen the boat in a while, and I left it on somebody else's property, and I'm hoping it's still there. Got a lot of preparations, little restaurant there, and got to get the boat, get some supplies, and get ready to go. Planning on setting sail from Memphis and spending 10 days on the river. So hopefully it's still there and in pretty good shape. We will see. And my automatic gate opener still works. So that's good. And if my reckoning is correct, the boat should be over here to the left. And there's the lake. You can see through the trees. And what do you know? Still there. Still there.
If my words did glow with the gold of sunshine, and my tunes were played on the harp unstrung, would you hear my voice come through the music? Would you hold it near as it were your own? It's a hand-me-down. The thoughts are broken, perhaps they're better left unsung. I don't know, don't really care. Let there be songs to fill the air, ripple in still water. When there is no pebble tossed, nor wind to blow, reach out your hand. If your cup be empty, if your cup is full, may it be again. Let it be known, there is a fountain that was not made by the hands of men, there is a road, no simple highway between the dawn and the dark of night. And if you go, no one may follow. That path is for your steps alone.
It's the second morning on the river. I'm down below Memphis, about 16 miles. Stopped here, got to do a little work on the boat. Probably going to spend the day here. And the sailing's been good. I've had a nice breeze and doing a lot of back and forth tacking, but getting downstream pretty nicely and able to communicate with the barges with the marine radio and an app called Find Ship, which is real helpful to let you know who's coming. So yeah, looks like it's gonna be a nice day. And here comes the Chris Reeves. That is a big barge right there.
Of a man's good name is acceptance of failure and losing a game with a smile and a handshake, quiet ever building rage. I got knocked around in a real small town and they poked and they prodded and marched me around for a laugh in the snow, tried to tear a good man's soul. A fool's gold, a beggar's bargain. It's too much time, space to get lost in a swamp or a road. Two, if you can let it go. Blood's thick, the water's deeper. The wine works fine, but the whiskey's cheaper. I turn it around quick before your sun goes down.
So I'm ready to cross the river and get out over there at the Tunica County River Park Museum. Really nice place to visit. And wouldn't you know it, there would be about five or six barges all converged right about the time I needed to cross over. Here comes three upstream. One just went by. And here comes another big boy coming downstream. Man, it's amazing how these guys maneuver those things. And this is a fairly narrow channel here. Here they come. So I'm just gonna sit tight here, fix me up a Mountain House meal, and enjoy the pretty day.
Beggar's bargain is too much time. space to get lost in. Swamp on the road, two if you can let it go. Blood's thick, the water's deeper, the wine works fine, but the whiskey's cheaper. I'm turning around quick before your sun goes down.
This is a little rundown on the equipment that I used on my sailing trip on a catamaran down the Mississippi River, about 40 miles, spent about 5 days out on the river. Start with this communication devices. I got a Garmin Mini here. They cost about $350. You have to buy a subscription with it. It's satellite communication. If you get in a real jam, there's an SOS button. So for safety purposes, it's a good thing to have anytime you're in the wilderness. This is a Cobra Marine radio. It cost $89. It's pretty indispensable on the Mississippi River. It allows you to talk to the barges, let them know where you are, where you plan to go, ask them which way they're going so you stay out of their way. They were easy to deal with, the barge captains, and this is, a Cobra, cost $89, was very helpful out there. I had a Pacific Crest two-man tent, one of these little tables that are like a stool. They're real handy. A little folding chair, a Scorpion 45 degree sleeping bag, which is nice, but probably could have used a little bit warmer one. And then I never really had a fire much, but I did have some things to make a fire. And on sandbars, not a lot of wood and not a lot of reason for a fire. Usually I like to always have a fire to camp, but I only built like one small fire the whole time. And then the headlamp was indispensable. I also carried several flashlights, but the headlamp is the thing to have. Some bear spray, fortunately, never had to use that. But I just wanted it along, a hunting knife. I don't even really think I used that. And then my water purification system, getting water out of the Mississippi River, I would filter it through this platypus gravity works, or gravity works platypus. My favorite water filtration system. It's really easy to use and makes a lot of water. You just get a scoop of dirty water out of a creek or river, hang it up and let it filter into the cling bag. You do a backflow thing once it starts, but it's really easy to use. I decided to add this to my water purification routine, this Grail GeoPress, real easy to use. It eliminates viruses, so I'm kind of a fan of these things, Grail, GeoPress. I would also boil my water in this jet boil, which I also used for just cooking, but the jet boil is really nice, which I would use to cook these meals right here, Mountain House Meals. Really good food on the trail. Hard to beat those Mountain House meals. I took some instant Starbucks coffee. It's pretty good. Actually, it's very good for instant coffee. A few Clif bars. Those little towels come in handy. That spoon right there. Those really work well with the nails because you got to stir them. And I had the life straw here. I never used it, but I always just carry it as an extra backup. And I also had this trail camera that I set up. I only used it one night, and I haven't even actually looked to see if there's anything on it yet. I need to do that. I don't think I got anything based on the lack of footprints around my tent. But one night I did have a set of footprints that came from one end of the bank to the other and walked right by my tent. And I wish I would have had it up that night, but I forgot to put it up that night. Anyway, that's pretty much a rundown of the gear that I use sailing down the Mississippi River. One other piece of equipment that was very vital was the phone charging system. This is a Goal Zero, and it worked very well, better than I thought it would. I was fortunate that I had plenty of sunny days, but I found that even an hour or two of sunlight would charge that battery there with something. I also carried this other Goal Zero. I think it's called the Flip 36. It's supposed to have three phone charges in it. I never even had to use it because this solar-powered unit did the job. So I thought I'd mention that as well.